We're going to cover nouns in this lecture. Nouns are a part of speech. We're going to cover about 8 major parts of speech. And why we're doing that is because when we are going to solve a lot of questions on based on grammar, then we're going to use this terminology. That is why we're not going to go in detail in covering the basics about grammar, because no one's going to ask you find out the noun in the sentence, identify the verb in the sentence. No. What they're going to ask you is, what is the error in this sentence? And there you'll have to identify that the noun is not agreeing with the verb or something like that. So how does that work? We're going to cover basics of grammar in these few lectures. Let's start with nouns. Nouns are people, places, things, entities, basically, that we reference to in any sentence. For example, if I say happiness is not my cup of tea, so the noun here, happiness is not my cup of tea. The noun here becomes Then again, if I say Rajesh is the worst student, so you'll see that we have these nouns. Now, if you take a look at all the nouns that you encounter in your daily life, you'll see that there are a lot of varieties of nouns, abstract nouns, proper nouns. But we're only going to cover two major varieties, which are and the other one, which is this. These cover these, that is why they're called the major two types of nouns. These are common nouns and proper nouns. Now, common nouns are those nouns which are used to refer to a group of entities. For example, when we say mountains or mountain, when we say man, when we say woman, when we say camera, when we say study, when we say anything that references to a set or group of entities together, it is called as common noun. And what are proper nouns? Proper nouns are single referential entities, which means that if there is a mountain and there is a particular mountain that I am referring to, for example Himalaya, if I refer to the Himalaya, I say that that's a proper noun. If I say Rajesh, that is a proper noun. If I say Mini the Moocher, that is a proper noun. So in this sentence, the Guptas are great neighbors. In this sentence, the Guptas were referring to someone in particular, becomes a proper noun, and when we are referring to a set of people, this becomes a common noun. Right? There are a lot of variety of nouns. For example, some nouns that are going to confuse you definitely are abstract nouns. Abstract nouns are those nouns which you cannot touch. These nouns basically you can touch. For example, proper noun. You can go out there and shake hands with the Guptas. Common noun, you can see your neighbors, you have the touch and feel factor over there. But with happiness, you don't have any touch and feel factor. Happiness, reality, love, hatred become abstract nouns. This is just one variety. There are a lot of varieties that you're going to encounter. But my advice here is, focus on what is noun. Focus on the common and the proper nouns, and these are major varieties that cover a lot of other varieties. And try and understand What role do nouns play in a sentence? See all that you read and try and focus on which are the nouns, what are they doing, are they the doers in the sentences. This will help you in understanding and highlighting what rules that we are going to use later on, how are they going to function. Okay, nouns play a key role in grammar, so be good with that.